Those hearts behind me are a sign of a baby villager being born. In Minecraft 1.14, having villages is even more important than in the versions before. The way to build a breeder changed a little bit, but is actually not more difficult than it used to be. You just saw one baby being transported out of the system. So in this tutorial today, I will show you how to build that specific design for a very easy infinite villager breeder in Minecraft 1.14. So we'll begin with the baby villager pickup area, which is just a 4x4 platform where you place one solid block here and then a wall of whatever material you like all around the platform, leaving empty that one block here where we will pick up the baby villages. And then you just place a water bucket in that corner so all the villager babies are pushed up into the corner where the rail will be. So in order to take out the baby villages, we place a powered rail here and then build a stair that goes up two blocks and has a powered rail here, and then we go to the other side and place a block like so, against which we place a dispenser filled with minecarts that will now automatically be refilled as soon as we wire it, and one minecart will place in here that will endlessly go up until it can pick up a baby villager and then enter the system. We'll place a return line here and put a redstone block here to power that one, and then two away from that powered rail we'll place a detector rail, take out that signal here and all the way long into that block, which we can just do with regular redstone all the way like so. And now whenever the minecart leaves, the next one will be dispensed. And now it's just placing a redstone block every 10 on the upper rail and placing two powered rails on the upper. Of course, you need one behind so they don't connect, and one on the lower rail, and then you'll have a long line. And the goal at the end is to have 100 blocks covered out of the system. That's very far out. And then here to pick up the minecarts when they come back, you want to place a hopper on top of that, a block next to it, a block of sand on top of that block, a cactus on top of that, and then rails going into the block on top of that hopper. So every minecart, when it comes that way, is broken and picked up by the hopper. After you reach the end of the rail, you want to place four more blocks like so, then two blocks going to that side, then go up by one and into that line. You want to place a detector rail here, power that that block actually, put an activator rail on that one, then connect it around here so you have a line connected, activator powered rail here. So now every minecart will be sent back immediately. Every baby villager will end on that block, so if you put two blocks here with sticky pistons facing towards that block, and then a construction like so with a redstone torch and the repeater, then those pistons will extend. And if now you take the signal coming from the detector rail, then every minecart will automatically open that block, making the baby villager fall, and then you can build whatever underneath to pick up the baby villagers, collect them, sort them, whatever you want to do. Now we'll extend the glass wall surrounding the collection area upwards. You have to make sure that there's no solid block next to the cactus so he doesn't break. And when you reached that height, you can just place a ring of solid blocks, and then you want to build water funnels that go four out in each direction at the center. I'm using glass block because I can, but of course you can use whatever block you like. Then you surround them by a line of whatever block you want. That's all design choices. And then with a too high wall, and put some water buckets into the corners and signs in the center to make the water streams connect in the middle and the villagers drop down. In order to have those signs ending the water streams, you have to place them like so on top of signs that are in the shaft itself. Now the water streams will end here and work perfectly fine. Now your system should look somehow like that, and if a villager baby falls into there, he will fall into the system, be picked up by a minecart and send it off. Next, you want to place a ring of dirt in the center, then two lines of dirt all the way surrounding that center, and in every corner three on each side of the corner like that, and the lower half slab here. And then you want to place any solid block like so here and surround the whole breeder floor like that. And since the crops need to grow for a while, then the next step would be to put water buckets into the corners where the half slabs are, hoe all the land, and then plant any crop that you want, preferably potatoes or carrots. Now you want to place trapdoors on each of those 4x4 holes, making sure that the ones that are on the sides have the trapdoors outside, so there is no line of trapdoor where the baby villagers later can walk out of the breeder. And then you cover that with any light emitting block, so you light up the farm and in the same moment only allow the baby villagers to leave. Next, you surround the whole breeder with glass walls in a pattern like that, which leaves open those two blocks, and then you place a composter on top of each water and a bed wherever you like, somewhere next to the composter. Next, in every corner you want to place like a roof above the bed and composter to make sure that any villager present when he gets up or works doesn't jump on top of the composter and from there down onto the farmland, so he doesn't destroy the farmland, because otherwise you would pretty fast lose those two blocks or three near each of the composters. And then you are ready to place your four villagers that will run the breeder into the system already. And you see they all choose a bed, they all turn into a farmer villager, so now all the workstations and bed are in use. When you're sure that every of the four villagers had chosen his bed, you can place the four beds on those corners that are just to lure the baby villagers out of the system. And then you need to build a spawn-proof roof over all the farm that extends at least three more blocks out to make sure that no lightning can hit your villagers. And it's best if you place it also like three blocks up, so if a lightning hits the roof, the villager is not in the radius for being turned into a witch. So here you can see the system in work. The baby villager comes, he is sorted out, let's say, and the minecart is sent back. So the breeder is working fine. It can produce up to six baby villagers per Minecraft day, since villagers can breed up to three times per day. But that only happens if the baby villagers leave the breeder fast enough. Otherwise, the maximum is the four that the beds allow for. So I hope the tutorial was helpful for you. If you build that breeder in your world, tell me your experiences and what improvements you might need. See you next time. Bye bye.